Oxygen is amazing. It's a molecule that's composed of two oxygen atoms that are bonded together. And when this molecule is mixed into water, it's known as dissolved oxygen. Oxygen is all around us, and we depend on it to breathe. You know, fish and aquatic life also need oxygen to breathe, but they breathe dissolved oxygen. And if there isn't enough dissolved oxygen in our streams, lakes, or oceans, fish and other aquatic organisms could die. No! But what exactly is dissolved oxygen? Well, when we dissolve anything, it means that we mix a substance into a liquid, and then that substance seems to disappear. Poof! Let me show you. Here I have some sugar. When sugar is dissolved into water, it seems to just disappear into the water. It's the same idea with dissolved oxygen. Oxygen molecules get mixed into water, and it looks like those molecules disappear. Let's take a look at the dissolved oxygen cycle so we can see the different ways that dissolved oxygen enters our waterways. And one way is through rain. During a rainstorm, water flows off the land and runs into streams, rivers, and oceans. And this movement of water, waves, and wind causes the water to connect with air. And this helps change the oxygen in the air into dissolved oxygen in the water. Another way dissolved oxygen is introduced into the water is through aquatic plant photosynthesis. When plants use the sun's energy to make their food, one of the byproducts is oxygen. Did you know that half of the oxygen produced on Earth comes from our oceans? The photosynthesis of ocean plants and plankton create a lot of oxygen for us to breathe. As you know, our oceans have salt water instead of fresh water, and salt takes up a lot of space in water, so there's less space for oxygen to dissolve. If there isn't enough space in the water, dissolved oxygen will escape into the atmosphere. That's the air you and I breathe. I can almost smell the ocean waves now. Well, now we know what dissolved oxygen is, and we also know that aquatic organisms such as fish, invertebrates, and plants need dissolved oxygen to breathe and thrive. This is why a healthy water ecosystem with well-balanced dissolved oxygen levels in our waterway is so important. Now, there are several things that can affect the amount of dissolved oxygen in our water. One big factor is pollution. Pollution can cause algae blooms, and these algae blooms can deplete the oxygen from water and cause dead zones that have no oxygen and therefore no aquatic life. Other factors that affect the amount of dissolved oxygen are really low or high temperatures, the movement of water, and how much salt or salinity a body of water has. All of these factors change the amount of dissolved oxygen in water, and this impacts the overall health of the ecosystem. That is why we monitor and measure dissolved oxygen in our waterways with a variety of instruments so that we can identify sources of pollution, such as nutrient runoff from the land. Typically, aquatic life needs dissolved oxygen levels above 5 mg/L for survival. And as you can see in this chart, the minimum tolerance of dissolved oxygen for fish is 5, right here in the middle. I'll use these dissolved oxygen meters to measure the amount of dissolved oxygen and the temperature to determine if these are a healthy environment for fish and aquatic plants. The warm, polluted water beaker has a reading of 4.1. The cold water beaker's reading is 9.5. And the healthy water beaker, well, it has a reading of 9.2. The cold water and healthy water beakers could sustain aquatic life. but the polluted water can't. We mentioned that water temperature plays a big part in the level of dissolved oxygen. The colder the water, the more dissolved oxygen there is. Now, molecules in colder water are closer together and they don't move around as much, so more molecules can fit into the same area. I like to think of these molecules as all cuddled together, keeping nice and warm. Warm water, on the other hand, contains less dissolved oxygen. The warmer the water, the less oxygen there is for fish to breathe. Now, in warm water, the molecules start to move around and bump into each other, and this reduces the level of oxygen. And I like to think of those molecules as just too hot. Whew. And they don't want to be next to each other. In fact, I don't want them next to me, they're too hot. Whew. Now, you may have heard concerns about ocean temperatures rising. Well, now you understand the dangerous impact that higher water temperatures have on our aquatic ecosystems around the world, and the negative impact of pollution. But you and I can do our part to keep our waterways clean and healthy. Don't pour harmful chemicals or unused medications down the drain. Dispose of them properly. And don't flush wipes. Oh, they add plastics and chemicals to our water. Here, take a look. This is a flushable wipe that's been sitting in water for a few hours. Look how cloudy that water has gotten. Ew. And the wipe hasn't even dissolved. Double ew. Ew. Ugh. What else? Oh yeah, don't over-fertilize your lawns and don't over-salt your sidewalks or your driveways during the winter. These chemicals can end up in our water and suffocate our marine life. And please pick up after your pets. Their waste too can end up in our water if it's not picked up. And finally, make sure to recycle as much as you can so that trash and other debris don't end up in our water. If each one of us puts just a little bit of effort into protecting our waterways, we can have a positive influence on our aquatic ecosystems. Thanks for watching.